Hey everybody, welcome back to Skylanders Superchargers on the 3DS, and in this video we're going to finish up the Glorious Tour. This is the first tour of the game, basically the first map. If you missed the first video, you should definitely check that out to see what this game is all about. Anyway, the first level here is Chompy Mountain. We've been to this area before, but this is a different kind of race here. Well, actually it's not even a race, it's more of like an obstacle course, I guess, and it has its own objective. But yeah, let's go to Chompy Mountain, and the mode here is Chompy-geddon. And I'm going to play on the hard mode because it's not that hard. It really isn't. I do have to scan some characters in because they leveled up on the Wii U version from playing that yesterday. So I'm going to skip ahead a little bit. Okay, so I scanned a bunch of characters in so that their levels are updated. And I also scanned in some characters that I got between the last recording and this recording, which is only a handful, but I don't even remember what kind of race this was. Oh, okay, so land race. Okay, let's go with Dark Spitfire, and let's use his vehicle, Dark Hot Streak, and we'll use the supercharged version.
Something's gotta be done about these chompies. Good thing we've got our racers. Drivers must eliminate as many chompies as possible before the time runs out. Racers, start your engines!
Three, two, one, go! Okay, in this race, or whatever you want to call it, the main object here is to run over as many chompies as possible, and the amount of points you need, you get points for running them over. The amount of points you need is indicated on the top. And the more you run over, like in a row, like the more points you get, like a multiplier. And I believe the gold chompy that I just grabbed there automatically gives you the times 5 multiplier. Plus it gives you, I think it said plus 125. So those are pretty much invaluable. I think there's two that I know of in this course. But yeah, this is pretty fun. I do like this one. Oh man, I missed a bunch there. I'm actually not sure if you can beat it on hard without getting the golden chompies. Oh, there's another one right here. There we go. But yeah, those are the only two that I know of. There might be more, but those are the only two that I've seen on the course. It might help to drift a little bit, but I'm not that great at drifting. This final part here has a bunch. We'll see if I made it, because you get a bonus for how much time you have left at the end. See if that pushes it over. Oh wait, it did. See, you can see the best score at the bottom. So yeah, even if you don't make the target score initially, the time you, amount of time you have left will help push that your point amount of points you have up, so you can get the target score. I mean, as you saw there, there is room for error. I mean, I missed a bunch of chompies, but I still got the target score. Okay, now let's continue to the next course. Okay, now that we've beaten this Chompy-geddon level, let's open up this Stargate. You only need 5 stars, I have 12. And we can open this treasure chest. Let's see what's inside. The acrylic spoiler. Oh, I think that's for Splat's vehicle. Okay, well, I don't have that one yet. Actually, that's not even out as of this video, so I can't even do anything with that yet. Okay, next up is just a regular race. This is Robomail Forest. Okay, for this one, I'm going to be using Supershot Stealth Elf in her vehicle, which I haven't summoned yet. No, I guess not. Okay, let me summon that in real quick.
Stealth Stinger.
Okay, and these are the different configurations. But I'm just gonna use the supercharged one, because I don't even have anything else unlocked yet.
Hello, race fans, and welcome to Robo-Mill Forest! This peaceful forest glen is a collision course of wackiness, as it's been infested by a gang of lovable trolls and a giant robotic lumberjack intent on its complete destruction! Well, this should be fun. Racers, start your engines! 3, 2, 1, go!
Whoa, was I the only one to get the boost there? Well, that's pretty cool. Alrighty. Oh, this is a pretty cool course. There's actually a lot of, you know, hazards here. They have, like, the buzzsaws. There's a lot of these boosting circles, too. Oh, spiderwebs, that's another one. If you fly into it, you get stuck for a moment, but thankfully there's a boosting circle right behind that one. It's kind of like a trap. I mean, you do get the shortcut with it, but, you know, it slows you down first. So I don't even know what to think of that one. I usually just avoid it, but I just wanted to show what happens with the spider webs. Okay, I took some really heavy damage at the beginning there. There was kind of a lot going on. Oh boy. I might wipe out here. Oh no. Well, he had some courtesy to leave me with 6 HP. Okay, I wanted to go for that circle, but I needed the cake. Oh, and I'm about to get wiped out anyway. Down to 6 again. Oh, yep. I wiped out, but somebody next to me, like, almost crashed into me, so they ran into that pillar. Oops. Okay, who's this? Oh, that's Jetvac. Okay, I'm gonna avoid that one for now. You can also go down there, but you have to go through a web first. So, I don't know if I'd recommend that. I've been down there before, but I don't remember, like, if there's any benefit to going down that way. Oh, I wiped out. Alright, so it looks like Dive Clops is in first. I shot down Jetvac temporarily. Okay, he's... Oh. Just like a few more shots and I should get Dive Clops. There we go. Yeah, when that happens to you, it's really devastating. Like, Dive Clops, see, he fell down to fourth and he was in first. Okay, we're on the final lap here, and we're actually almost at the end. This is not a very long course. The end is actually right near here, and I almost ran into that saw. There we go. I think, except for that second lap, that wasn't too bad. Alrighty, she leveled up. And I think the Stealth Stinger will level up too. Yeah. Okay, let's move on. Alrighty. As you can see down here, there is a path blocked by an undead gate. As I figured out in the last video, these elemental gates are for vehicles. So you need an undead vehicle to get through here, and I don't have one yet. I don't know if I'm, like, if I will get one or not. But if I do, I'll go down there. But I do have to skip it for now. I mean, I don't really want to, but I have no way of getting it, so... Yep, I'll have to skip it for now. I'll just come back, maybe, if I do get an undead vehicle, I'll come back and unlock that in another video. Alrighty, but for now, we have another race here. This is going to be a land-based one. This is Trollympic Village. Who do I want to use? Let's go with Donkey Kong. And I'll use his supercharged barrel blaster.
Barrel blaster. You can never keep a good bad guy down. And they're all right here in the Trollympic Village, where the best of the worst in Skylands gather to see who has what it takes to take home the gold. And apparently nobody told them you were racing today, so they should be particularly nasty. Watch out! Racers, start your engines!
Okay, Trollympic Village, as you saw in the preview, actually has a bunch of these, like, big chompies that are running around, and they can run into you. Okay, let's see if I can get rid of them. Oh, I'm out of ammo. Oh, I missed that jump. You're supposed to jump into that circle for the boost. There, I got somebody. Oh, was that jetpack? I was gonna see if I could drift there. Here we go. Nice. Whew. Yeah, you can shoot them. So that you don't run into them while they're... I think they were skiing. These ones skate in place. Wait, do they move? Well, they're doing, like, pirouettes. Obviously, you want to watch out for those. And who is this? He's, like, zoom right past me. Oh, it's Jetpack again. Ah, I can't shoot him because he's too close. Ah, my drift got interrupted. Oh, I think his health came back. Oh, wait, no. Never mind. I think you know what? When the reticle is blue, I think that means they're invincible. Because he went from, like, red to blue to red again. I know I wasn't hitting him that much. There we go. It's pretty easy to get a boost there. Ah, I keep missing the cake. I need some health. Oh, here's some. Okay, I missed out on the item on the right side, but there was another one there. There's another cake. I feel like I have to shoot him down so many times. Actually, there's quite a few people behind me, like directly behind me. I missed that again. Okay, the potions are nice, but I don't need those right now. I especially don't need this right here, this mask. Okay. Whoa. Okay, I got the cake. I was aiming for that one. Okay, they don't really pose a threat, but I feel like I should shoot them down anyway, just in case. Alright, I have a pretty good lead here. Whoa! I don't know what he was doing, but Fiesta just shot through and almost passed me at the end there. Yeah, that was pretty crazy. Alright, so that's a win for Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong. He's in the vehicle. Surprisingly, that was only 2 stars. It seemed like they were a lot more difficult, because if you notice in that race, I had like 3 or 4 people on me almost the whole time. Okay, let's continue. Okay, magic item vault. What is this? Oh, I guess I summon a magic item here. Alright, I'm gonna grab one real quick. Okay, I summoned sparks, but they gave me one star. I wonder if I summon more and it'll give me another star? Oh, okay, well, let me grab another one. I wasn't sure that I needed more than one. Okay, there's the healing elixir. Alright, might as well summon a third one. Alrighty, and there's the time twister. Let's see what happens on the map. Oh, you just get 3 stars. Okay. Well, that's a pretty neat addition if you... You know, I miss out on this one, so I can't get any stars from that. So, I mean, that kind of makes up for it for now. Alrighty, next up is Robomill Forest. This is a sky level. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna go with hard mode. I've played this one, it's really not that bad. Let's go with, yeah, I showed these last time, I was just looking at them again. Okay. Okay, I think for this one, I'm gonna choose Hammer Slam Bowser in his Clown Cruiser.
Clown Cruiser.
Feel the need for speed? Then this challenge is for you. It's time for the racers to hone their afterburn skills. Racers, start your engines!
This is another challenge, and this one requires you to hold the R button to fly through these rings, and you get points. Okay, you can't hold in the R button like the whole time. Nope. The afterburn has to like recharge itself, so you kind of have to like pick a good time when to start it and stop it. With the afterburn, it's harder to turn, so I mean the best course of action is just to activate it when there's a bunch of rings and let go when there's like a big turn coming up or something. And try to get the time too, so you have more time to complete this. I think I got it. But yeah, for the hard mode you need 3750. I'm not sure why you need that extra 50. I guess that's just an extra ring or whatever. But it's not that hard. Like, see, I have almost a minute left, a little under a minute, and I'm already almost at the goal. Just need a few more rings. But yeah, that's why it helps to grab the stopwatches. You get more time to do this. You know, as long as you don't like run into anything or miss a bunch of rings or whatever, it's pretty easy. Yep, I already passed it, and I'm already well over the goal here. There you go. It kind of like ran out, so I couldn't activate it in time. Alright, so basically I'm just killing time right now. Let's see how much I can get. I mean, you don't get anything for a high score, but I just want to see how high this point counter can get here. Okay, I got a couple more rings at the end there. But yeah, it's pretty easy. I almost got like double the target score. Yeah, that's it. I do like these challenge ones. I mean, racing is, you know, pretty fun, but these challenge ones are a nice change of pace, and I actually like them a lot. Okay, that leveled up now. All right, let's continue. I think that might be it for this video. Because I don't remember seeing anything else on the map. I think the last thing is the actual trophy, but that's just a cutscene. Oh, we have to unlock this first. Okay, the Stargate, this one's 7 stars. I have way more than that. And we have the treasure chest. Let's see what's inside. The magma injector. Alrighty, this is the Glorious Cup. This is where you pick up the trophy. It's like a cutscene that plays.
Welcome to Racelandia Wrap-Up. I'm your host with the most, Pendergast the Magnificent. Today's top story, the first tour has come to an end, and what a tour it was. It had it all. Thrills, spills, close calls, and crashes. What could the next tour have in store that could possibly top the extravaganza of racing that we just witnessed? You'll have to tune in next time and see for yourselves. I'm your host, Pendergast the Magnificent, and this has been Racelandia Wrap-Up.
Okay, I was going to end the video after I got the trophy, but after this was recorded, maybe like a day after this was recorded, I received a surprise package from Activision that contained all of Wave 1, so all the characters and vehicles, and most of Wave 2. Like, not all of the figures were there, but, you know, nevertheless, I got a lot of figures, so I was very happy about that because I didn't have a lot of figures for this game. So now I can show more stuff, and one of the figures was Fiesta's vehicle. So now I can actually unlock this undead elemental gate because I didn't have an undead vehicle prior to that. So let's scan that in. Alright, cool. Now we can actually go through here. I do want to reiterate, I think, what I said earlier. I don't remember if I said it, but there's going to be some elemental gates that I won't be able to unlock, like, either anytime soon or, you know, it kind of depends on some things. But I had the undead one in particular, so I was able to open that. Okay, and, oh yeah, this one. Okay, this is the Pander Castle Skyride. We've seen this level before, but this is a new type of race. This is a ghost race, and it's pretty much what it implies. It's a race against, like, a ghost. You've probably seen those in Mario Kart. Alrighty, and for this one, I actually recommend playing it on hard. The ghost, at least for this course, is extremely easy. Let me put it this way. I tried it on normal, and I was, like, 10 seconds ahead of it, of the ghost, maybe more than that. And then I was like, oh, let me try it on hard. Okay, I ran into a part of the level, and they passed me, and I was actually able to beat the time I had in medium. So that's how easy this one is. Alright, and I'm actually going to use a new character here. I haven't scanned her in yet, so let's do that real quick. Okay, and this is Stormblade, who is a new character in this game. She's a brand new supercharger character, and I'll be using her as well as her vehicle, which I need to scan in right now.
Sky Slicer.
Okay, this is the Sky Slicer. This is the supercharged version, since this is her vehicle. Now, if you notice, there are some animations for the characters when they warp in. Like I said, I don't know the situation is going to be with regards to, like, collecting all of the characters, but, you know, if I can make, like, a video showing all those animations, at least for the new characters. I don't know about everybody, because that's a lot of work. But, you know, like I said, if I'm able to get all the characters, I'll, you know, make a video about that.
Is the Challenger fast enough to beat the best lap time on this track? Let's find out! Racers, start your engines!
Alrighty, the opponent here is, I guess, the Machine Ghost. That's what the opponent looks like anyway. But yeah, like I said, you can beat this even if you make a little error. I mean, I was able to. But, yeah, since your only opponent is the Machine Ghost, or whoever that is, a ghost, there's no, like, enemies trying to shoot you down or anything like that. So, yeah, you don't have to worry about anything except for, like, the obstacles here. I do recommend using the boost in, like, these straightaways like this one here. And wait for it to recharge, and then you can hit it again. But yeah, as long as you finish this race in front of the opponent, then you win. See, I'm like almost 4 seconds ahead. And I'm actually almost at the end already. Pretty much once I hit this, the finish line's not too far from here. Yep, it's right there. And if you see on the bottom screen, the ghost has disappeared off the map because I'm too far ahead of it. But yeah, that was on hard mode too. So that's why I recommend playing that on hard. That's an easy amount of stars right there. Okay, 103.20. And the goal is 111. Morning glory. So yeah, you have a lot of room for error there. Well, maybe not a lot, but like a little bit at least. Okay, and we have 3 stars. Okay, she leveled up. She had some levels because I used her on the Wii U version. And I have not used this one yet. Okay, once we are done this one, we can actually open... there should be a treasure chest behind this. We can open that. And then after that, that'll be the end of the video. I'm actually kind of glad that I didn't edit this video yet. I mean, I wasn't sure... Well, what I was going to do is just come back to this if I had a chance. But since I, you know, haven't uploaded this well yet, I can add this onto it. Okay, and there's a new mod for that, which I believe is Roller Brawl's vehicle, and she's not out yet as of this video, or her vehicle. Alrighty, so this will be the end of this video. In the next video, we're going to get started with the Spectacular Tour. This is the second one out of 5 regular ones. And the first area here is Chompy Mountain. We have a Drift Mastery Challenge. Alrighty, thanks for watching, everybody, and I will see you next time.